Welcome to this How to Use Solar Controller video. Powering up your controller. When your controller is first connected to a battery, it will enter power-up mode. This means the LED screen and all the icons on the display will flash for a few seconds. Toggling the display. To view your battery's current stats, press the B button to change the information screen. These stats are battery voltage, charging current, battery state of charge, and amp hours charged. The amp hours represent the value of amps going to the battery from the solar controller. Selecting a battery type. To select your battery type, hold down the B button for 5 seconds. Release the button when the display shows blinking values on the bottom row. The controller has 4 charging profiles: lithium, sealed, AGM, and flooded. Use the B button to toggle through the profile options. When you have selected your battery type, press and hold the A button for 5 seconds to confirm it. When completed successfully, your selected battery type should now be visible on the bottom row. Sun and Moon Symbols. The LED screen has a sun and a moon symbol that indicates whether your panels are producing a charge. The moon symbol will be visible when there is no charge being generated, such as at nighttime. The sun symbol will show when the panels are producing a charge. The numerical values shown on the screen will also indicate how many amps are being supplied to the battery. USB port. The controller is also equipped with a USB port to charge handheld devices. Try to remember to replace the dust cover once you are done using the port. Performing a soft reset. If you encounter any issues with your controller, we recommend performing a soft reset. To do this, hold down both buttons simultaneously until the display begins to blink. This helps to reset the system, sort of like turning your computer off and back on again. During this process, your controller settings, like your battery type, will be saved.